like the menu, but
I'm going to go on to me because
we just have the franklinreporter.com news site. Now we have
in the community from the Wawa's and 7-Elevens, ShopRite, and Stop and Shop. It's here in the municipal building. It's in the senior center, it's in the community center, the libraries, Somerset Diner, Franklin Park Diner. Wherever we walk in the door and say, would you like to hand out this Franklin Reporter that we want to digest? And every single person I hand a newspaper to, opening it, reading it.
Is that delivered?
It is not currently delivered directly. We did do that prior to the pandemic. We had issues with the post office changing the postal routes. We had people calling us and saying, I didn't get my paper. And the post office said, oh, well, we changed the route this week. And it also became a nightmare to manage, and the expense just got out of control to justify what was going on that was not meeting anybody's needs. So we decided, okay, we're going to do it ourselves. And we're printed down south near, I guess, Cherryville area, because there's one printing organization in the state who will print on newspaper. And we want authentic newspaper. So we take the time when the paper is done. It goes down to South Jersey, and one of us goes down and picks up thousands and thousands of newspapers and we go to work. So we are everywhere.
The cool part about our printing plant is it's totally sold out. There's a huge solar array outside the parking lot, and they use soy-based paper, so we're very environmentally friendly.
Where are you located? Over here?
We're in Village Plaza.
Okay. Any questions? How many subscriptions now? How many people have?
You know, just not subscribing. It's a free paper. So we put out thousands of copies every week, and they're all gone. Every month, rather. And they're all gone.
We have over 5,000 of the newspapers in the big south.
I believe that we
You pay for the website.
Yeah, the website is subscribed.
The website costs you 10 cents a day.
Yeah.
Nobody's getting rid of 10 cents a day, but it's a value increase. For us, it was people pay for what they want, and they want what they pay for. And we don't feel that news is a free concept. It takes decades of education, training, and experience to bring you what the Franklin Reporter advocates for. Bill has had laws passed. He's had the congressional outcomes as a result of investigations. And he hates when I tell this story, but I'm going to tell it anyway. When he worked for the Courier News, he also worked for the Asbury Park Press, he covered a township meeting in Bendis, New Jersey. And they were discussing something that was, at that point, very innovative. It was the thermal imaging camera. Thermal imaging camera, which maybe a handful of fire departments in Somerset County were privileged to own, because they were $25,000 to $30,000 a camera. And Bill thought, you know what? This is not right. This is not fair. Lives can be saved. Lives are not being saved because it's too expensive for every fire department in the state to have one. What are we going to do about this? So he corralled Kip Bateman, who was the senator at that point, as well as Pete Biondi, and the three of them tirelessly put out article after article after article. And then Governor Christie, the governor at the time, Christie Whitman, right? Governor Whitman finally took notice. There was a surplus in the budget, and she got on board, and she signed it into law. We went to the signing ceremony. He still has the pen. She signed it into law. We went to a location in Edison where they had been testing grounds, where they actually set a building on fire, and you could see the thermal imaging camera go to work, where you can see through the walls, you can see objects, you can see animals, you can see people who are trapped. It is literally like sleeping. And she signed it. And as a result of that effort, as a result of your editor, the Franklin Reporter advocate, he's going to kill me. You know who's every fire department in the state has one.
Thank you
so
for your
this is who's running. This is who is running your editorial. When he comes to all these meetings and he stays here till 10, 11 o'clock, and then he goes back and he unravels the stories and he writes.
I don't
you never sleep.
I'm a hologram.
You are a hologram. find or something
different or something unique about getting news that's local. So I think we all care about that. So let me ask you this though, what part of the content is strictly political and what's not?
It depends.
Would you not typically do
it? It depends on the season. I mean, this is October, this is March.
Send press releases to you?
Absolutely.
Games have changed since I was
a high school.
I used to go to the bowling matches when we first started. I just can't get out there anymore. But I'll come to track. We'll do the track meets. Friends in high school started hosting the groups, the NCAA groups.
Do you want to track meet?
Yeah, so we'll be there. We'll be there covering that. I won't give in-depth stories about that. I'll do photo things, and I'll maybe summarize stuff. Basketball games, as best I can, I'll summarize the games. Because these are shooting games. I can't be taking notes. Football, baseball, softball, girls hockey. And I guess, starting next September, I'll be covering volleyball as well. So we do as much sports. We're trying to present as much of what's going on in town as we can. So whether it's high school sports, I was even covering when we first started, I had a lot of time on my hands. I was even covering middle school sports. Nobody does that. But I just can't do it.
There's something we started about 5 years ago, and I'm particularly excited about it from kind of a long from my standpoint. We started at the Franklin High School. We thought this would be really fun to do a red carpet Joan Rivers kind of thing, and to do the kids and see what they're wearing. And it became, I asked two questions. What was the best thing that you experienced at Franklin High School? And what are your plans now? Every kid had something fabulous to say about their experience, or their teacher, or the course, or the interaction they had with their fellow students, or an activity, or an athletic, or an artistic. Every one of them had a solid plan. And it was so wide-range. I mean, it went from law enforcement to culinary arts to music and art to aerospace to engineering. It was so widespread in terms of their interests and in terms of what they felt they were prepared to do. It was so exciting. And we got such a good response out of that. We thought, you know what, this is very interesting. People are responding to the live feature. So out of that, we started doing live streams. I'm doing most of them, because I'm the girl. And we go into the community when there's a charitable event, when there's a personality profile that just needs to be shown. Because I think people relate to seeing other people speaking their hearts and tell their story. We did the most recent one, and we should all be going to this on Sunday, is the Empty Bowls event for the food bank. That's this Sunday at the DoubleTree, where it's a total fundraiser for the food bank. DoubleTree has donated every single penny that it would have cost them ordinarily back to the food bank. And we do a live stream talking. We'll do that. We'll cover the animal shelter. We did a live stream yesterday or the day before covering a gentleman from Little Rocky Hill, Bridgetown area. His name was Michelle Mahers. And Michelle Mahers was 100 years old. He was a World War II vet and a French resistance fighter, and as articulate as any one of us sitting at this table, describing the zeal he had for freedom. And it was just stirring and wonderful. He was just extraordinary.
I complained that they didn't ask the NHL suit.
They didn't?
He was being awarded the First Legion of Honor.
He was just wonderful.
Yeah, he was.
The French consul general had come down.
What you hit him?
And it was a very moving ceremony.
Exactly. They sent down a mixer one.
Yeah.
And we do those live for those who, for whatever reason, were not able to be there.
And last night, in Dallas Hill Test, was last night,
right? Yeah, Ramadan. Yeah, we're Dallas. There you go.
Yeah, live stream, the opening, the Ramadan ceremony, the lighting ceremony.
Even my Facebook, you didn't have Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
She's not anymore.
Facebook and YouTube.
Yeah.
We try to do that in all of it. We have 70 some odd different houses of worship in us.
Yeah.
And we, do our best. We haven't been to every one of them, obviously, but we do our best to present. We've been to all the temples. We have eaten around the world.
It's
different churches, temples, and mosques. I just want to say, in addition to, excuse me, in addition to trying to present all the political sides of what's going on, we have this fellow who is Franklin, made his mark in progressive politics as being a person who has opposed skinheads, opposed Nazis, the Battle of Champions. We had him on one time. We got some grief on that on the road from the right.
You're on your list.
We had a threat, which is an amazing pushback folks in this town.
Well, because.
Well, they called him Antifa, he says.
Well, he was a member, he is a member.
No, he's a proud member.
Exactly.
And there's nothing, hey, as I said yesterday, Michelle Walker is a member of the, he's an OG Antifa.
Yeah, theoretically, yes.
Go ahead, John.
And we've tried to go to different ethnic groups around town, and we've tried to go to different religious faith traditions around town. So we try to bring all of, you know, we say our motto is 8 villages, 1 community. And the reason I picked that is because we wanted to bring, let people know who their neighbors are. Sometimes this is a very large town, there's almost 69,000 people in this. Sometimes you don't know the breadth of what you have. It was 68,600 and something.
Mm-hmm.
And unless you're in the high school, unless you're in the schools and you're exposed to it,
there's well over 65 lines spoken.
Yeah.
Where is your lady?
No, letting people.
No, I'm good. Go ahead, John.
No, not my turn yet.
Yes, it is. It's your turn, John. You got the floor.
I'm here.
Behind
Johnny, you know our
group. Only gives a half hour.
Yeah, but half an hour, John. So
you've been waiting here for me to speak anything you've been in here.
Go ahead, John, go ahead.
The way I'll say it this way, let me say it. I think everybody in here heard that in your beginning of your publicity, publication of journals, writing, that all the people that you have given thanks to was the people that all my life I worked against. Did I say that right? No, I think I said that right. I'm going to say that again. For everyone that he gave their thanks to.
Who did we thank? Who did we thank?
Yeah. And look at the thing I say. Everything from looking on the people that I worked against. And that same attitude and thanks is being exhibited in the Franklin Township community. I wish that the spectator, newspaper, was back again instead of you guys to at least see printed the true community thoughts and aspects.
What's your
I've been here.
I'd love for you to document what you're saying.
Hey, can I talk to Sam? No, you're telling me not to get political.
I'm trying not to.
Go ahead.
We have exhibited in the past 10 years total trauma in the black neighborhood. The killing of 10 young black kids, 2 black ladies. We have exhibited total gentrification of the black neighborhoods. We have exhibited the annihilation of young black men economically without any economic supportive services. Some of that is due to ourselves, of course, ourselves. And there has been no indication that the Franklin News Record, the Carrier News, or the New Brunswick newspaper will not ever carry any article against this administration or the people thereof. You
John,
said 2 minutes ago, 3 minutes ago, right, Bill? You said,
I just have 2 words for you.
Yeah, I know what you're going to tell me.
Rajiv
Prasad.
Rajiv Prasad.
Yeah, I don't know what that means.
Michigan.
Franklin News Record is any indication of what's going on in Township.
Yeah, the Franklin News Record has been out of business for a decade.
Whatever you guys run. And they know that I don't like it at all, and I don't like what they report. Now, even with the gentleman over there with the Canal Walk, you know, there is a whole thing going on, which I cannot say now because they listen to me on the thing over there. But I will say this. If ever I can find a newspaper or a newspaper article or somebody that would publish what's actually what's going on in Franklin Township, I wish that they will not print that. I'll tell you that now. They will not print what's going on. I read the paper every day.
How many?
But they're beating me up. They're killing us in the minority community.
How many articles did you submit to this, John?
You ain't gonna print nothing I give you anyway. So don't.
Have you not?
Right. Hey, look. You don't have to say what he's talking, okay? I don't need to support him. I don't need to do that. I'm not printing. But I don't. Hey, listen. I'm talking to him. Yeah, I got it, Glenn. I got you too. Now, I wish that one time, there's one thing the spectators did do when they was here. They always printed what was going on in the community, exactly. What was up in the minority community? What was going on?
Such as.
Okay. Everything.
Such as. Johnny, have you seen how.
There's not a young black person that can graduate from high school or go to college and can come home to live. There is absolutely nowhere to live. There's low-income apartments in Franklin Township at all, under $1,000. There's nobody, there's no young black kid, and it's a black or Hispanic, and this kid can live in this, 80,000 people, can graduate, go to college, and come home to live. They cannot afford nowhere to live in this whole community. In terms of the Canal Walk and the...
John.
That whole thing out there, that whole thing, I had to have no industry.
John.
Now you need industry.
John. I'm going to have to stop you. I don't see where this is going. What's your point, John?
I'm making my point now. Gary.
Remember what you and I talked about recently?
Yeah, I didn't get photos. Did I get photos?
Please.
I don't know.
I don't understand your point.
Really? That's where I'm at.
Make your point.
Are you
okay? Let me finish. Yes. That the whole fourth, fifth, fourth black community is being devastated by the policies that's coming out of the city's administration.
Largely unsupported by the black community in Franklin County.
Let me hear from the
Okay, we're police.
developments, and Johnny was actually there when we presented the fraud presentation. It was I, Officer Reed, Officer Russo, and Dos Reyes was there as well. We go to the senior citizen meetings here as well. I just want to bring awareness, because I always tell you guys to lock your doors and, you know, be careful with safety things, but the fraud is becoming on an all-time high now. I know that I receive fraud as well, attempt text messages, links. Do not click the link if they send you a text message. If you click that link, they can take over anything. If you have an iPhone or Google or Samsung, they can take over your, and it could be from somewhere from Asia. It could be from Europe. You don't know exactly where they're coming from, and we can take a report. The police will take a report. However, there's no way we cannot track whoever is doing that. If it's out of the country, that it has to do with the FBI. So I just want to just bring some awareness. If you receive text messages, emails, even familiar, I know everyone here has an Amazon account. So just be, Amazon is not going to send you certain things that are, you're not familiar with buying, as far as a link, a text message, just randomly. It's not going to happen. If you're receiving phone calls for any police department stating that they want you to donate to the PBA, that is false. We do not do that. We'll send maybe a letter at the most. We will never send, we will never call and say, can you donate to our PBA? And there have been people donating to the state police PBA, and it doesn't exist. Now we have 15 citizens. This is the biggest.
He's the last to get
Rob's the editor.
He's not there.
So,
anything else? Anything else from the newspaper? We thank you for coming, and
always a pleasure.
We thank you, and the HRC can help you anyway. You know, I'm here, so we help you. And I know what the warriors are every day. Came to Mr. Solomon, and Mr. Solomon, they were here.
I'm gonna stay.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, let's continue the meeting.
So I was enlightening you guys about the fraud presentation that we were doing.
Continue with your report.
If we have been just given an open concept to people to talk to us about current events, their fraud issues, because actually there are new things that we haven't even took a report for. There's new things that's happening in fraud every single day. So if you do have questions, if you can, join those meetings, or you can ask me at the HRC meeting, and we can get more information. Next time I'll give you guys some handouts. John, you have to start the handout, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We give out handouts, and then I can kind of define every single type of fraud. These people are even going to nursing homes, and going to nursing homes and requesting money, life insurance. Check your account. Check everything. Check all your accounts, not just your bank account.
Yeah, I get a new phone call, which I never had it before, mm-hmm. and the phone call was from United States Customs Office. Mm-hmm. I introduced him as a United States Customs Office, that I have a package shipped from Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
You got that too?
Yep.
And the guy was asking all kinds of, they knew my name and everything, so I was surprised. And then I hang up.
Especially now, tax season. IRS will never call you. They will never call you. They will send a letter. So it's just sometimes it just goes above people's head. If anybody asks you for a gift card or to go to get a gift card, do not go to CVS or Walgreens to buy a gift card to pay with the gift card.
When he gave that presentation to the senior citizens, there was a number of them there that have gotten those calls and things, man. They were so happy. Oh, really? That was nice. Oh, yesterday.
Yeah.
So I keep getting this call from Doug Mallon, every 10 times a day, and I've been blocking each time it comes in, but they never say anything.
Mm-hmm.
I say hello, and they don't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
So all day today, I keep blocking the number, and they keep calling from another number.
Right, and I also have trouble with that. They do have an
877.
There is an app where it can. The only thing bad about this app, it will block every phone call that comes in. However, if you're not saved, sometimes, like, I have an 848 area code.
Mm-hmm.
I had it since I was a kid, so that's, I was from up north. I don't know why I have an 848 area code, but if I call someone who has an app, my phone call will not go through.
Mm.
Because it's an unknown number, so the app thinks it's a fraud or spam.
Mm. Mm.
So, sometimes I have to send a text message, okay, Malcolm, and so on. However, if someone's trying to really communicate with you, even family members, is your lost cousin ever going to ask you for $10,000 if they're in need? Maybe, however, I don't know, I wouldn't do it.
And how about the grandma?
It's nonstop. But they will call 100 grandmas. One of those grandmas are gonna just, how many do you need, baby?
No.
So, yeah. So you can always ask a lot of questions, and you'll kind of spook them out.
And then they'll say, you gotta take down this number, then the other person's gonna call, and you can give the money to them.
Yeah. Yep.
And now with the IGBD, they can personalize the call with the grandson's voice.
Right. Yes.
Right. So now it goes to the, off completely different level.
Right.
So we did, just for our 500 phone community, I had one of my cyber experts, did a session, because one of the homeowners, his WhatsApp app was taken over. And
WhatsApp's
getting eavesdropped by a different
user. They can take over your directory.
And,
hey,
profession, I can look at that.
They all in there, man. They all day long every day.
So our education was, can you look at
you know
your WhatsApp and find out if someone's looking at your WhatsApp? This was something very simple, and people found it very educational. But my question is, when you do these educations, when you do these educational sessions, how do we get to know about them? How can people log on and hear?
How can people log on and tap into your software?
How can people know about those sessions?
Oh,
and
no. Well, you know what, bro? What you're telling me, I'm going to tell my sergeant and let the detective bureau know, because they need to be aware of that. However, there's been calls that's probably familiar with something like that. With the WhatsApp, there's so many. I dealt with one of the last calls I had on the road before I was moved transitioned to community policing. The cartel text a random person. She happened to be Latina, and the cartel said, "I'm going to kill your family. Send over $20,000 right now. And I know where you live. I have your phone number." And said my last name. Said her last name. And she was in a panic. And she actually was not even born in Mexico, where the cartel was from. She just happened to get a text message. And I took maybe 5 reports about that same text message. So WhatsApp is tricky. But they can tap into your software. That's why if you click a link, you can click a link, and then they will take control of everything. And then they will start start transferring money to their bank account, from your bank account, whether your life insurance, mutual funds, anything. So I'm just trying to not scare you guys, but I'm just trying to tell you guys, you can be aware of all your accounts, not just your bank account.
And I'd like to get the information so you can share about when you're having.
Yep. So we have been going to all the senior citizen meetings. We have been going there, but we haven't been touching base. No, we go over here, right over here to the senior citizen building with the rec, and we partake with them. However, I can bring extra flyers next session, and if you want to hand them. If you want to hand some out, you can as well.
Okay. Anything else for the report?
No, that's all I really wanted to touch on.
You can give us a heads up whenever you do some sessions.
Oh, I don't know.
I'll send a thread with Gary. Gary seen me last week, bro. Right? I was in Europe. I was in your building last week, Gary.
They were my community.
Yep. It was about 15 people there.
They do a great job. They came down the hospital. They do a great job. Yeah. Hey, we don't know about them things, man. Them senior citizens, that they said, huh? Yeah, but you called me yesterday.
But even not senior citizens, only kids as well. Teenagers are definitely could be victims as well.
Okay, let's continue.
They won't go anywhere.
But anyway, if they can get the WhatsApp, what are you going
to
do?
If you just block them, or sometimes I just leave it, I just delete it. Just get it off my screen.
Okay, let's continue then. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
We have a perfect attendance tonight, except for Edna, who unfortunately had an accident, and she slipped and she hurt her leg, and she can't leave the house for at least 6 weeks. I had asked her, and I need the HRC's approval for this. As you recall, not at the last meeting, because I canceled the last meeting because of the ice and because I wasn't feeling well. I had asked her to write something up that the Chamber of Commerce asked us to send to the Township Council. Do you have this? Anything? Would you read the what I have in?
Oh, February 22nd.
Yeah, I have
committee.
The date of our next meeting is on Wednesday, November.
From the Chamber of Commerce.
Oh, I see. As per request from the Township Chamber of Commerce, Chairman Edna presents the following for the approval. We, the Franklin Township Human Relations Commission, HRC as a body, concerned about the future of Franklin Township and the elimination of empty storefronts, request the Council to work towards an efficient and timely resolution to the future of the empty former Kmart storefront in the Rutgers Plaza shopping center.
Okay, so do you have any, is okay, this, I plead your okay, if I should send it to the council on behalf of the HRC, so.
Weren't they knocking it down?
Because I have a solution for that. I really don't want to hear this. Tell them to build some apartments. Let that man build those apartments in that whole complex. So we have some affordable apartments, and somebody's trying to build them already.
Yeah.
That the community approves of. Please, let them build some apartments,
that's
some affordable apartments.
That's another issue, John.
It is, please.
That's another issue.
That's not going to happen anyway.
That's
an
issue.
But at least, I want them to solve their problem of the Kmart problem.
Giant.
Make those apartments. We all need those apartments. Then you have some people to go to the stores, over to that shop tonight, and all
John,
those.
John, that's an issue for the planning board, not for the HRC.
Well, I want you to
Johnny, listen to me, because you give me a hard time tonight, I'm going to ask you to leave, okay? It won't give me a hard time. This was an item that the Chamber of Commerce asked them to write. Nothing to do with the apartments. The apartments, if you have any problem with the apartments,
you said okay, Mark, didn't you?
Go to the planning board. But that's where you're doing that.
Yeah.
The planning board and the zoning board. Not here.
Not there. But we're going to prove it.
Well, it's up to you guys. You want to approve the resolution. If you approve it, I will send it to the council. But I need your approval. You want to read it again?
We, the Franklin Township Human Relations Commission, as an HRC body, concerned about the future of Franklin Township and the elimination of empty storefront requests, the Township Council to work towards an efficient and timely resolution to the future of the empty former Kmart storefront in the Rutgers Plaza shopping center.
Are you okay with that, everybody?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Can I see it? I'm sorry, I just need to see it.
The apartments, you know, that's another issue.
I know I have one to plan for.
But that's a good issue, but that's not our job. Okay, I'm saying, but the apartments, you gotta go to the planning board.
The apartments are really complicated issues.
But they have two
apartments. I don't want to do that.
Mr. Chairman. Yes, go ahead.
So this issue of the Kmart is really a complex issue. It's not as simple as for us asking them to quickly to come up with a resolution, because it's not going to happen that way. There are some legal issues they have to follow. There are some planning issues, and there are so many different departments.
That's why I'm asking.
I'm not so sure really what is this resolution is going to serve.
Okay.
So I'm not really 100% sure what do we mean by a speedy resolution, and what we think that they are slowing down and they are not working on.
That's exactly.
Yeah, I think they just urge them to continue to work.
Right. Yeah, I'm sure they are working on it.
Yeah.
And
that's
trying.
Why they just wanted us to help them push it along.
I'm sure they are working on it, but this, you think that this is going to help?
That's why I'm asking. If you don't want me to send it, I won't send it.
I'm just not sure what will be the value of this coming from us asking them to speed up.
You don't know they're working on it.
If you say we're concerned,
I think I know the angle. That's why I need to check up with the process. The angle is basically that nobody in this town wants to see a vacant building. That just welcomes, criminals, and it together. Because the council does need to come up with something, because it looks really deserted over there.
And that's
so maybe we should just make a little bit change in the language, mm-hmm. just to make sure they know the concerns that we have, that that has been too long vacant space,
yes.
and there is a concern about abuse of that space for criminal activities,
yes.
and therefore we are requesting the council to come up with a solution to that. Something like that, I think,
yeah,
might be more.
Yeah, be forceful. Be forceful, yes.
Yeah.
Be a little bit forceful in the writing.
Yeah.
No, I'm all right. If you want to write it, I write it.
Maybe we can change the wording a little bit to make it more explicit.
That's
why we are asking that.
Why don't we table this to this meeting and the HRC come up with something?
Okay, let's do that.
Let's do this.
I recommend that. Yes.
I'm going to table it.
Doing what we were hoping they would do.
in their power and try to get us to something.
Okay, is there anything else that we have a good time to come here?
They're trying to make us their job.
Anything else? If not, I'll issue a meeting to be adjourned. If you will.